what really helps is if you unmute your mic. Kind of glad I didn't have that going. I've got that going now, so now you get to hear me in all of my weird monotone mermaid glory, I guess. I don't... Okay, so now that I'm completely sure this is working, I'm going to take my ear monitor out so I don't have to hear my annoying voice. But you do! Fuck it. I'm not gonna apologize anymore. Do a jump! Yay. So this is Abzu, as you can clearly see. It is one of my very favorite games, mostly because I am way too into undersea life. It's pretty good stuff. Look at all these fishes. These guys are pretty good. Hey dudes. Now we gotta find the Garupa. This is my friend. Today I will name him Fred. Come on, Fred, let's go. One of my very favorite things to do in this game is to just find the meditation spots and just hang out there. But first of all, we're gonna get some Hawkbill sea turtles out of here. This is another favorite part of this game. You very quickly learn that I have very few not favorite parts of this game. Friend. Hey there, happy friend. I'm a robot friend. I really appreciate how they put in all these little details with these different kinds of starfish, and there was a little crab over here thinking about hiding around the corner here. And there's little sea urchins, which is really cool. Initially I thought it was just going to be fish, which for me would have been just fine, because I do enjoy fishes, but I thought it was really neat that they also did other small things. Here is the aforementioned meditation spot. And this is kind of neat because you can just kind of chill and do this, and if you played the game before you know this, but... And just watch all these fish doing their fish thing. The only frustrating thing is sometimes it just gets stuck on the same kind of fish, and it's like, yeah, I saw that fish. It looked exactly like the other one. But for science reasons, this is... These dudes. I fucking love these dudes. Big old sheep heads with their derby faces and mouths. Not really sure if those are teeth or what, but occasionally they open their mouths. I don't know. It's kind of cool. So let's get back down to business and find some more robots. Fishies out of this hole. Now we got some sharks. Everybody likes sharks. Well, maybe not everybody. I enjoy them. So, see, it's also you're gonna find out really quickly that I get distracted super easy. And yes, there's a little tiny seahorse. There's a whole bunch of them, actually, just kind of hiding over here. sort of difficult to get them in the camera right, but there they are. I can barely see them because they blend in with the kelp so well. And here's another robot friend hanging out with the urchins and the little crab who is just gonna scuttle off over here. There he goes. Oh no! Let's find another pool, which is here. I'm gonna get these guys out of here. Got some trumpet fish! Oh yeah, these goofy looking dudes! I love these so much. Look at these little dorks. I don't think that they much look like trumpets, but they definitely look weird. I'm not gonna pretend that I know the actual science around those guys, but they look like they might be related to seahorses. If anyone's actually able to chat and can Google that and prove me wrong, please, please do. I invite you to do so. For now, let's just try to find, I know there's at least one shell in here, and I don't exactly remember where it is. But one of my favorite things about this game is exploration, and oh, check it out! We have like a little lobster dude down here. He's probably gonna run away when I get too close. Yep, there he goes. Oh, there's the other robot. Cool, 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 cool. Look at all these starfish, this is so cool. This is neat. Yeah, here's a robot, we'll get him out. And then I'm gonna double back and try to see if I can find the shell in here. Because if I recall, there should be one in here. Let's take a look. There's some more seahorse friends right down there. Shell's at. There's a sea turtle. There's a weird hole in this rock for no reason. Other than I guess it looks cool. Criminy. What is this? This was the way in. That is not helpful. Thank you, Cables! Everybody in the chat is my friend Cables. Who's going to be backing me up with ocean facts. That's a fish fact. Shell, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like it's somewhere around here though. It was like. Oh, there it is! Of course. I just missed it because I got distracted by looking at things. That's how I do! Oh, cool! We've got some big sea urchins under here. They are large friends. Yeah. Yeah, girl, you got me. Okay. So now that I've found... No, you can absolutely do... oh, hello! And now we have my robot husband. Hello, robot husband. but yes, I was going to say, Cables, we can absolutely fish are delicious with lemon on them. I completely agree with you in that respect. That is very, very true. Gonna go through this little cave. Oh no, it's a shark! Oh no! Today that shark's name is going to be Clarence. I've decided this. That's him name now. Him named Clarence. See, it feels like there should be something important in here, but I really don't think that there is, so that's why I'm kinda swimming around trying to look for stuff. Thank you so much! I would love to have a wonderful merm header. That would be great. Oh, here's a shell. Here comes the shell under the ocean. I'll put it in a weird kind of Moroccan or... I gave up. I tried. I was trying to make a Steven Universe reference and then I failed quite miserably because I couldn't think of words. I'm really bad at talking to myself, you guys. Like, really bad. To what I like to call the Moon Kingdom. Oh, and then a thing that I figured out the other day, because I did not know this before, these dudes here will appear when you find the shells in the game. There should be another one floating around here somewhere. Yep, there he is. So you'll get a whole bunch of these ancient Nautilus bros that hang out in here once you have finded the shells, which I think is kind of cool. But yeah, now we go to the Moon Kingdom and I'm going to be a moon princess and I just have to... throw my soul sphere into this egg. I don't know. Sentient corn? I think I already have an opinion on sentient corn. Like, and it's what the hell are you talking about, Cables, basically. Now I'm putting the monitor back in my ear so I can tell if you guys know that I'm vaping. You can't. You can't. You will never know. Except that I just told you, so... whatever. Anyway, in here... there's also a meditation spot. Girl, when I gonna start streaming competitive Battlefield? Let's try never. And, I have a vague feeling that this channel ain't gonna get many followers because all I'm gonna do is stream Abzu and look at fish all the time. And you know what? That's fine by me. This is a rooster fish. And you can tell that it's a rooster fish because it has that weird comb on its back, which is kind of nifty. His weird comb friend, and he just eats everything. He's very hungry. Most of the fishes in this are pretty dang hungry. Okay, it did the crackly thing. It's doing that thing with the audio. And, Cables, maybe you know if you know anything about the lore in this game. And here's a Trevally. I love these guys. They look derpy as crap. But why does it do that thing where it, like, kind of crackles out the music every now and again? Because I don't know. If anybody wants to, like, look into that for me, I would be... really pleased, to say the very least. Let's see if we can get it to show me one of these nifty stingrays. Nope. Just wants to look at the unicorn fish. Really? Never? It never did the crackly thing for you? I'm sure you guys heard that audio. I'm not sure why it does that, but every now and again it'll do that, and then the music will eventually come back, but... I think it might be related to the swimmer, yeah. Nope, I guess we don't get to look at this friend today, so let's just go find one and I'm gonna take a ride on him. Where you at, buddy? No, don't swim away! I'm not as fast as you! Oh god! Oh, I made it. Yay! Woo! It's an interesting bug. I legitimately thought that it was just part of the game. I don't know. I thought it was just them talking about... Spoilers! Swimmer friend is a robot. Okay, now we gotta go through this here. I love going through the temples. They're really nifty. I guess, for lack of a better term, iconography looks super ancient Egyptian, which I think is really neat. They've got all of this Sanskrit and stuff as well, which is all definitely my aesthetic. So I really appreciate that. Thank goodness for mute buttons on my microphone, because y'all didn't have to hear me coughing. Going through this tunnel. Oh no, you guys. Clarence is gonna come back. Everyone say hello to Clarence. Ow. He's gonna munch on one of my robots. Sorry, robot. And now we're gonna go way down here. Because there's things to find. There's something really big that I just passed. Trying not to get distracted, but I don't know, I have to stop apologizing for getting distracted, y'all. I have to stop apologizing for that, because it's just gonna happen. You put a mermaid in a game where you can, like, basically just explore the ocean, she's gonna get distracted. Speaking of which, directly to my left here, horseshoe crab, how cool is that? And... yes, exactly, that's me basically this entire time, like, ooh, look, distractions! Also, ooh, look! Foreshadowing! Right here! Anyone who's played the game knows. We'll see that later. What is this? Oh, it's just little lobster friends. We got some turtles in here. And I'm fairly sure there is a shell down here somewhere. It's just looking around down here is kind of difficult because it's all... Oh, yep, there's a shell. And, anyway, I was going to say it's difficult to look around down here because the water is just so dense. What in the crack? Oh, that was just... never mind. Thought it was some kind of eel, but it was just a piece of the rock, I guess. Okay. There should be some more little things to let animals out of here, I think. I guess we'll find out shortly. Maybe not. If not, I'll just play through this again. Let's be real. I'm gonna do this about 17,000 more times. Hey, Ragnar Octopus, if you want to ask me any questions about merm culture, now would be a great time to do so. Just throwing that out there. So the viewers at home can learn all about mermaids. Pardon? Now we have a loading screen. This is called a loading screen. And that was me sipping a soda. Okay, so we have a question. Are there any fishes that do not have merm counterparts, or is it a one-to-one kind of thing? You know, it depends. According to lore, which has recently come to light, which I completely disagree with, mermaids are born because a fish and a human mated. That is not how merms are created. Merms come from space, and they're deposited on the ground, well, on the seabed in New Zealand, and they come in abalone shells or those other kinds of shells that I can't remember the name of right now, pawa shells, which is a specific kind of abalone that only grows in New Zealand. These are actually facts. That's where merms come from. Anyway, as far as I know, there are no fishes that do not have merm counterparts. I mean, check Tumblr for mermaid art, and you'll see that that's all fact. All of it is facts. So every fish, merm counterpart. There you go. That's the simple answer. Also, mermaids are not born from humans and fish going at it. They come from eggs from space. It's like a Transformers thing where they decide at birth what tail they want. You know, I think actually it's probably regional, or depending on what part of the ocean specifically you end up in. I don't know if it's necessarily by choice. I feel like one would adapt to their environment. So I guess yes. That is an interesting question though. Man, it's weird being put on the spot with these. Oh man, trumpet merms would be amazing. Trumpet merms would be rad. I still want to see a jellyfish merm. I love these parts. I love them. Hermit crab mermaids. It's merms. I don't know how that would work. Crustacean mermaids. Would they still be called mermaids at that point? If they're little hermit crab friends? Like, I legitimately don't know. Because they would have a shell, not a. Well, I mean, I guess you would kind of have a tail. At that point, I would pose this question to you. What do you think about the possibility of, say, the possibility of, like, crab mermaids. But at that point, I don't feel like it would really be a mermaid anymore. It would be more like those weird, like half spider things that they have in Final Fantasy, I feel like. And that's more of a. I mean, it's still a monster girl, which is rad, but it's not necessarily the same thing, if that makes sense. Crab maids. Yeah, I mean, I guess, but I don't feel like you would call them that. Would you? Oh yes, we got the humphead Ross. I was under the impression that these guys were called Napoleon fish. Can either of you check and see if Napoleon fish and the humphead Ross is the same, or Ras, or however the heck you say his name, is the same fish, or maybe they're just similar? I don't know. Okay, no, I like that. I think. Whoa. Just ate a really big fish. I'm sorry, I got distracted. Oh my god, he just ate a. Oh no. He's eating everything. This guy is real hungry. Oh no. Gonna eat all my friends. Oh, they're the same? Okay, so it is a Napoleon fish. I like to call them the derp of the sea because, seriously, look at this guy. He's a derp. I got to see one in person in an aquarium recently, and they're great. I love them so much. Now we got a shark. Another one of those guys. Okay. The tater tots he keeps in his fish pockets. What? Why would you keep tater tots in your fish pockets? Are there undersea potatoes? I don't think that that's true. You know what I really like doing? This right here. And I just kind of get sucked back into the ground. I mean, that's not really what happens, but it's fun to play with. Okay, so. All right, here we go, here's some more. This is what I was talking about when I said it's very easy to distract me while I'm playing this game. Stuff like this. Don't give me things like this to play with if you don't want me to just like swim around in circles doing dumb stuff like this. This is great too. Yay! It's way too much fun to play with. There's my dolphin friends. And oh yeah, pufferfish! I've never gotten close enough to one of these guys to get a real good look at him, but one of the best things about this game is just how detailed everything is. It's so, so pretty. And accurate and detailed. Nothing up here. Just looks like there should be. Already opened that one. Oh, that's where, okay. I knew there was something up this way, I just forgot exactly where it was. No, seriously, like, doing sick flips is one of my favorite things to do. Scared them all. Just gotta get your speed up, like, way too close to the surface is the only thing. See if I can do it now. Doing sick jumps! That was kinda weak, let's try it again. That was also not great. I'm not having a great jump day, you guys. I feel like that was the tunnel I came out of. And it's gonna be like, no, you can't go this way. Oh no, this is where the second robot was, or the first one, rather. I have yet to find a second robot, if a second robot exists. Solid 7 out of 10. I've done way better, is the thing. I've done far better jumps than that. Now, where in the heck is this last little... I don't even know how to do that. No, I can't. I cannot do grind into a 360 nose bone. I feel like you might have just made that up. I think maybe that's not a real thing. Oh yeah, the last level. It's because you have the superpowers. There, I found the last thing. And this time we're letting out Vaquita. These guys are so cool. I've never heard of them before this, actually. Vaquita are like these little, tiny, almost dolphin-looking guys. There's one that way. I'm gonna try to get closer to him. Except now everything's trying to follow me. Quit following me, fish! Oh my god. not going to be your kind of game if you're looking for dying and or killing. This game was created by the same folks that did the game Flower that we believe was originally on the PS3, and a game called Journey, which I have never personally played. But it's a company that more does, like, I don't know, game experiences rather than running around and shooting. There are some kind of like emotionally rough parts, but there is really no dying and no killing in this game. You just go around, you look a fish, and if you're into that, then this game is definitely for you. I freaking love it, but I'm also a mermaid, so I'm genetically predisposed to enjoy this sort of thing. Swordfish! Marlins, JK. So, Robin Lord, I was actually joking with Ragnar Octopus when I first played this game. And I'm like, at some point, I'm going to have a microphone. And someone is going to... Yeah, sweet jump! Someone is going to come in and be like, so, why can't you shoot fish? And that was basically what I thought was happening. I guess that is not what is happening, but that is why I was laughing so hard. Because, yeah. I was fully expecting someone to get angry because, no, you can't shoot or kill any of the fish. It is not allowed. And I'm gonna have to do that prior sequence again because that is where that ancient Nautilus shell is that I always miss. I saw it a minute ago and then just kinda went right on by it. I know someone will, and on that day, I will laugh harder than I laughed when you asked that question, I assure you. Excuse me? Oh, that's sussy. Can I see the orcas do their dancey thing? I love this part too, when all of the kelp grows in. It's so pretty. Okay, now we're gonna go looking for the meditation spot. Which is somewhere in here, I think. Is there a meditation spot in here? I don't know. We're about to find that out. Is there anything over here? There doesn't appear to be anything over here, and it's not turning me around yet. That's odd. Okay. There should be a meditation spot in here somewhere, so that's what I'm searching around for. For a minute. Right above the bridge on the rock wall? Okay. Is this the one that I couldn't find? I bet this was the one that I couldn't find initially. Well, it'll wait. I'm riding on a sea turtle. Priorities. Taken a sea turtle adventure. Okay. Right above the bridge on the rock wall. This is the same. Of course it's the same one. One that I couldn't find initially and then felt really dumb about not being able to find the first time. Well, dude, like once I get the meditation spot, you're gonna go nuts. It's it is well worth $20 for a game, I assure you. Like, did I just miss it? Where is this? Oh, no, that's not a meditation spot, that's coral. That too, you can get it on Steam or Xbox One or PS4. I have it on Xbox One, and I can't find this meditation spot. Oh, there it is. I can see it. It's right there. The orcas are like, it's over here. This way, small swimming friend. Now let's look at some fish. Parrotfish are great. They have beaks! Anyway, regarding meditation, this is one of my favorite features, is you can just sort of set this and just kind of watch it for a while. And it'll switch between different fishes, and it's kind of neat. And it's also semi-educational because it shows you which fish you're currently watching, has the name in the lower right-hand corner, which is kind of cool. Trying to get it where it'll show me one of the orcas, but apparently it just doesn't want to do this right now. When you're looking at the different fish in meditate mode, it switches between them completely randomly. So sometimes you'll get to look at something that you want to, sometimes you don't. This is one of those times when it's being kind of silly and just showing me every parrotfish in the universe, even though there's clearly blue tangs in there and all kinds of other stuff. No, my game, well, yeah, my game sound cut out. It did that thing again where it, like, does the crackle. You should be able to hear me just swimming around now, but the music does occasionally cut out. Ragnar Octopus and I were talking about that a moment ago. I think he looked into it, and someone on Reddit said that it is actually a game glitch, but the music will come back. Yep, there it is. There it is right there. Right on cue. another nifty 10. One of my favorite parts is coming up because it has one of my very favorite fish in it. And oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Oh geez. Oh, well, I was 4 for 4 on shells for a minute there. And then I missed the one in the fast part, and welp, that was that. There's probably also a shell back in there, but I don't feel like looking for it right now. Ah, I love this. Right down here, when they're schooling like this. Most commonly, if you ever see videos of fish doing this, they'll show, I think, anchovies a lot because they're really reflective. So their scales will kind of shine. There's actually, at least there was last time I checked, there's a movie on Netflix where it just has like music and then just underwater stuff like this. Obviously it's not interactive because it's a movie, but it's really good. But there is one where they have fish schooling like this. So yeah, it's always a good time to watch that. Now we have some. It is indeed a bait ball. If anyone is a fan of Tsurikdama, you'll remember that from that anime. That also has fish in it. These stripy guys are a different kind of marlin, and I don't remember what kind, but I'll try to grab onto one, and then we will know. Okay, nope, not close enough. Uh-oh. Oh, ugh. Are too fast. Oh, got one! It is a striped marlin. Of course it's a striped marlin. That's literally exactly what it is. I feel very silly now. Let's, just for the heck of it, go down this way. I don't know if we can get all the way down to the seabed, but we can at least try. See, you watch the real science stuff. I'm just talking about animes. Holy jeez, there's a whale down here. I didn't know there was a whale down here. It's a freaking humpback whale. And what appears to be a meditation spot. Neat. Or a shell. I don't actually know what that is. Nope, that's a meditation spot. Go ahead and grab that so we can look at stuff. Oh man, yellowtail snappers. See, now I'm just getting hungry. This isn't fair. Cables! Cables, don't be pedantic. Cables! Cables! Here's a mahi-mahi. Again, this is just gonna make me hungry.
Oh yeah, look how delicious you look.
Showing me the delicious ones, game! Have mercy! Oh my god. This is just not fair. Oh, look at this little dude. How cute is he? He's so small. Uh-oh. Oh no, the game crashed! No!